Okay, good evening. We're going to get started.
Yeah, that's your copy. You're going to have a copy.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining us this evening for our regularly scheduled monthly council meeting. For all of you joining us in the audience and everyone viewing in at home, Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Councilwoman Bermudez?
Present.
Councilman Clark?
Present.
Councilman Deutsch?
Present.
Councilwoman Fox?
Here.
Councilman Gale?
Here.
Councilwoman Rosado?
Present.
Councilman Sanchez?
Present.
Councilwoman Thames?
Present.
Councilwoman Winch?
Here.
We have a quorum, Madam President.
Thank you. Can we all stand for the pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. This evening we have a point of personal privilege by Councilman Clark. Do we have a microphone up here? Okay, so he has the wireless mic. So we can join him up front.
Check if it's on. Good evening, everyone. And tonight's personal privilege and honor of, because I want to greet them as they come. Tonight's personal privilege is honor of Black History Month, and this is, I believe it's the fourth annual African and African American History Bee, and I would like to recognize the following individuals as well as their coaches for Team Achievement First Summit, who were the winners of this year. And so, I will read the citation, and then I'm going to read the names, and they all read the same. So it says, Court of Common Council, Hartford, Connecticut, official citation presented to Sonic Mejias. All right, go ahead. On behalf of the Court of Common Council, I would like to congratulate the winner of the fourth annual Calling Our Brothers African and African American History Bee, and as a member of Team Achievement First Hartford Summit. Your commitment to your education is why Hartford is a great place to work, live, and play. Without your many talents, beacon of hope, Hartford is today. This is one of the many reasons you are being honored today. And on behalf of the Court of Common Council and the residents of the City of Hartford, we thank you very much. And we have Mr. Irwin Hurst. Congratulations. Trevon Leslie. Joey Mestre. Karen Bush. This guy is one of the coaches, and he is a phenomenal person at Trinity College. Mr. Matthew Rivera. And his name is Matt with a Dream. Check him out on IG. All right. Another phenomenal guy at Trinity College, Mr. Giovanni Jones. Mr. Brian All right. Another phenomenal guy at Trinity College. I'm not going back up here. And last but not least, Pastor Frank Tremine. Not here? All right. You want to come up and accept the form? Eddie, you come up too. These two gentlemen right here, Mr. Stephen Wilson and Mr. Eddie Brown, have been founding members of Calling On Brothers since its inception, and they continue to do a great job as being mentors to many of our young men in our community schools in Hartford. Anybody, can you all come to the come on this side, yeah.
On behalf of Calling All Brothers, I am just excited to just be here and for us to be our fourth year being able to go into the schools in the North End to provide mentorship, but also being able to prepare these young men for the African and African American History Bee. Each category is roughly over 50 facts that they have to memorize. And just to be able to expose them to different facts about their culture was just enlightening. And then to see these boys bring home the trophy was exciting. I also want to just thank our coaches. They are students at Trinity College, and they took time out of their busy schedules to come to Achievement First and to come and help coach these young men. And again, thank you, thank you, thank you so much. We truly appreciate this. Thank you.
Okay, now we will move on into our business agenda. So, Mr. Majority Leader, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam President. Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining us at this meeting on February 25, 2019. I'd like to make a motion to put the following items on the consent calendar. Item number 2, item number 7, item number 11, item number 12, and item number 14.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly seconded to move items to the consent calendar. Any discussion? Councilman. Hearing none, please, Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Councilwoman Bermudez?
Yes.
Councilman Clerk?
Yes.
Councilman Deutsch?
Yes.
Councilwoman Fox?
Yes.
Councilman Gale?
Yes.
Councilwoman Rosado?
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez?
Yes.
Councilwoman Thames?
Yes.
Councilwoman Winch?
Yes.
Pass.
Mr. Majority Leader, you have the floor.
Through you, Madam President, I'd like to make a motion to receive the following items. Item number 5, 8, 9, 10, and item number 13.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly seconded. Any discussion on the received items? Hearing none, Mr. Clerk.
Madam President, if I may, item number 13 is listed as a received item. But I think that was intended to be received and acted on. That was the...
It should be under this.
It's a report from the ordinance.
It's a report, well, I think it was intended to have the resolution attached. Mm-hmm. It's the resolution that was referred concerning deferment or allowing any federal employees who were furloughed during the recent government shutdown to potentially receive 60 up to 60 days to pay their
yeah.
property taxes without interest. So the intention may not have come forward properly, but the intention was for us to take action on it, I do believe.
Correct. Corporation Counsel, can you weigh in here with respect to the technicality? Because our expectation was that this went to public hearing, was favorable, and that we were going to be voting on this today.
Madam President, I understand what the intent is. I'm informed by the clerk that the sequence of events is, even though there was a public hearing, there was this is a report of the committee, because we're talking about an ordinance. The ordinance would then be on the next council agenda for action.
So we wouldn't see it until next meeting because of
that's,
it being an ordinance?
That's correct.
Thank you for the clarification. Any discussion? Hearing none, Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Councilwoman Bermudez?
Yes.
Councilman Clark?
Yes.
Councilman Deutsch?
Yes.
Councilwoman Fox?
Yes.
Councilman Gale?
Yes.
Councilwoman Rosado?
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez?
Yes.
Councilwoman Thames?
Yes.
Councilwoman Winch?
Yes.
Pass.
Mr. Majority Leader, you have the floor.
Through you, Madam President, I'd like to refer the following items, and as once I'm done with it, my colleague, Minority Leader Bermudez, will describe each one. Item number one and item number three with the replacement to the Legislative Affairs Committee. Item number four to the Operation Management Budget and Government Accountability Committee. And item number 22 with a replacement to the Quality of Life and Public Safety Committee.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly seconded. Any discussion? Ms. Minority Leader, you have the floor to.
Item number one, a resolution confirming the appointment of Samuel King, Edith Pestana, Carrie Provost, Alexander Rodriguez, and Tom Swar to the CODI Advisory Commission on the Environment. Item number three, resolution confirming the appointment of Raymond J. Delphin and Calixto Torres to the Hartford Parking Authority. Item number four, resolution authorizing the city to accept $1,715,280 from the State Department of Transportation for improvements to the Bose Barlow Bridge and Main Street. Item number 22, resolution for emergency services known as Hartford, through emergency services known as Hartford Police Department, Fire Department, and all other municipalities integrate onto the state radio frequency infrastructure.
Any discussion on the referred items? Hearing none, Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Councilwoman Bermudez?
Yes.
Councilman Clark?
Yes.
Councilman Deutsch?
Yes.
Councilwoman Fox?
Yes.
Councilman Gale?
Yes.
Councilwoman Rosado?
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez?
Yes.
Councilwoman Thames?
Yes.
Councilwoman Winch?
Yes.
Pass.
Mr. Majority Leader, you have the floor.
Through you, Madam President, I'd like to make a motion to postpone the following items until March 11, 2019. Those items are item number 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and 21.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly seconded. Any discussion on the postponements? Hearing none, Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Councilwoman Bermudez?
Yes.
Councilman Clark?
Yes.
Councilman Deutsch?
Yes.
Councilwoman Fox?
Yes.
Councilman Gale?
Yes.
Councilwoman Rosado?
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez?
Yes.
Councilwoman Thames?
Yes.
Councilwoman Winch?
Yes.
Items are postponed.
Mr. Majority Leader, you have the floor.
Through you, Madam President, I'd like to make a motion to withdraw item number 6.
Second.
Yeah, there's no vote required. The mayor asked to withdraw that. So duly noted for the records. Mm-hmm. Moving on, you have the floor, Majority Leader.
Through you, Madam President, I'd like to make a motion to put the following items on action. Item number 23. Which is resolution requesting that pursuant to his authority under section 2-487 of the Hartford Code of Ordinance and upon recommendation of the mayor, the Court Common Council hereby recognizes Dillon Stadium as a priority park improvement project and authorizes that $1.2 million from the investment income of the Hartford Parks Trust Fund be used to fund ongoing improvements at Dillon Stadium.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly seconded. Any discussion on item number 23? Councilman Deutsch.
Yes, through you, Madam President. There's some sentiment for referring this to a committee or another public hearing because of the statement about certain contributions and a lack of clarity among some members of the public and I must say some members of the council. So there's some sentiment, which I share, to have this come to another committee, as we usually do, because if it's such an important project to the city, and there are many in the city who would like to weigh in on some of the features, including the contribution from the Hartford Foundation and some other elements. So I'd like to have it postponed, and I would like to... I'd like to refer it to committee. I'd make a motion, but there's a motion on the floor to accept it.
Motion on the floor.
I have to. Yeah. Is it proper for me to make a motion to refer to committee? I so move.
Which committee?
The Committee on Planning and Economic Development.
So there was a motion on the floor, and now there is a motion to refer the item to committee, which does take precedent. Is there a second?
Second.
A motion has been made and properly seconded to refer the item to committee, to PEDH. Any discussion on that? Councilwoman Winch?
Oh, yes, Madam President. I think that we should, one, address the issue tonight, but I, too, also had some concerns about the usage of park trust funds. But having a conversation with the treasurer since those concerns have been addressed. Another issue that I had concern with, that there was some conversation earlier about us not being to have the city's historical Turkey Day at that location this year. So if I can have that addressed for the public record, then once we get past the voting for to refer or not, if somebody can address that, mm-hmm. I would be good with clarification.
Thank you, Madam.
You gonna address it now? We can wait to do the vote, however.
I'll just address it right now, if it pleases the court. To Councilwoman Winch's question, the turkey game will take place at Dillon Stadium if the field is completed. By way of this resolution, on Thanksgiving Day, and after the soccer season, the field will be transformed from soccer to football, and that will be going forward as well.
And just to add to that, I think the issue and the confusion was around when the fields can be transformed from soccer to football, because there is an associated expense with that, with the lining. So every time you move from one field to the next, there's a cost associated with it. So from an efficiency and cost perspective, they wanted to have the full season of soccer be completed and then transition to football. And they should be able to accommodate given the schedules of when soccer season ends and when football begins. And by the time we're at the turkey game, the field should be ready to be able to be in use for that. So that was just further clarification
So do we know when soccer season, Madam President, do we know when soccer season ends?
Mid-October, the end of October. And so with football, it kind of overlaps that preseason, but it's like in full swing by the time soccer ends.
I'm just concerned about the turkey game because I just know Hartford High gonna win. So I want to make sure that we're on that field.
Right. Well, we confirmed that it will be ready if the field is ready, right? If the construction goes according to plan and it's operating, we will be able to have the turkey game there.
I'm good.
So there is a motion on the floor to refer the item to committee.
I'd like to ask something. May I?
Okay.
Yes, I just want to remind everyone that if this is referred to any committee, then it will be a serious delay in that stadium development, and therefore we may not see that game or any other game for that matter.
Thank you. Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Councilwoman Bermudez?
Yes.
Councilman Clark?
No.
Councilman Deutsch?
Yes.
Councilwoman Fox?
Yes.
Councilman Gale?
No.
Councilwoman Rosado?
No.
Councilman Sanchez?
No.
Councilwoman Thames?
No.
Councilwoman Winch?
No.
Fail.
Now we're back to action.
Okay, now we are back to action. And so any discussion on the item on the floor for action? So I would like to just state for the record and for clarification purposes, because I do appreciate and understand and agree with my colleagues who wanted to refer the item to committee, but I think from a timing and a sense of urgency, we just don't have that luxury. Hence why this resolution is put forth. And it's widely known the issues that are surrounding the actual developer and his own set of issues that are kind of separate from us getting the stadium done. Because I think we all were committed from the very beginning in this endeavor was to redevelop Dillon Stadium and get it back to a community asset. Yes, we hope and we still hope that we are able to get a professional soccer team and our initial agreements and intention with HSG pan out positively. But regardless, we need to get the stadium, keep it on track and get it developed because ultimately this was a community asset and restoring a community asset. And so the resolution that is put forth today is a matter of keeping the project moving, keeping the momentum moving, so we can have a stadium that is back developed for the community that kind of, again, all the other issues aside, I think we all would agree that we want Dillon Stadium to be back online and as a community asset. And so what this resolution is really intending to do is to transfer already previously authorized Dillon Stadium improvements from the Parks Trust Fund, which has been cleared and vetted from the treasurer and the mayor, to use those previous allocations to front load and kind of the monies that are needed to keep the project going. With the anticipation that Hartford Foundation for Public Giving, which has already verbally agreed and the administration has been in conversation with them with respect to them putting forth $1.2 million to reimburse the city. So at the end of the day, the monies that we are transferring now should be a revenue neutral event and should not negatively impact the monies that are already existing in that fund. It's just a matter of borrowing to some extent to keep the project going in anticipation that it will get backfilled and reimbursed, if you will. And again, this is all in an effort to keep the project moving and on track and on time. We are already a little behind schedule, so we're really trying to keep pace and keep up. Because again, this is about restoring a community asset, and this is what this resolution is doing, if you will. Minority Leader.
Thank you. Through the Council President. We certainly agree that there should be restoration and new development in our city, especially with major assets like this one. The main concern, I guess, on this side of the aisle is just there have been folks in the community who want more information about this, and so at minimum, that's why we wanted it to go to committee. But I think it, you know, why not then have a community conversation for the mayor's office? So that's another thing to consider.
Yeah, and I think actually that is helpful feedback because I do think there's a lot of misinformation, anxiety about kind of what's happening and all the things that are the controversy that's surrounding the project. So I think that is something that we can actually bring back to the table and saying, you know, let's have a community update on the Dillon Stadium project so we can lay out kind of everything that has happened and is going to happen and how we still keep it on track. So I absolutely agree with that and more than happy to work with the mayor's office on that. Council, Majority Leader.
Yes, thank you, Council President. I appreciate what you said. Basically, you said the majority of what I would have loved to have said, but I'm asking my colleagues to please consider voting yes on this item. It's not about a small group. It's about the community itself. It's actually about the city. This is a jewel in the rough right now. It's a jewel that's been dilapidated, unmaintained. It just ran into the ground. Now we have an opportunity to bring it back. And when we're bringing it back, you think about the community, the kids, the neighborhood that this stadium is in. Think about your past if you enjoyed it. But I am asking that you join us in voting yes in a unity that the community needs. And I'll leave it at that.
Great. Just one last thing to the point, to your point about the community conversation. Assistant Majority Leader just mentioned to me it probably would be a good idea for us to have a Dillon Stadium project update at our next PEDH committee meeting, so that's something that we can do fairly quickly. And so that next meeting is March 6th at 6 o'clock, so we'll work towards working with Development Services and Eric Johnson and getting the necessary parties to that committee meeting.
Call to question.
Second.
Okay. Mr. Clerk, call the roll, please. Yes, this is vote. We're voting on calling the question.
Councilwoman Bermudez.
Abstain.
Councilman Clark.
Yes.
Councilman Deutsch.
Abstain.
Councilwoman Fox.
Abstain.
Councilman Gale.
Yes.
Councilwoman Rosado.
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez.
Yes.
Councilwoman Thames.
Yes.
Councilwoman Winch.
Yes.
Pass.
Now we go to the question, which was the original action item on the floor, item number 23. Mr. Clerk, please call the roll.
Councilwoman Bermudez. Councilman Clark?
Yes.
Councilman Deutsch?
Abstain.
Councilwoman Fox?
Abstain.
Councilman Gale?
Yes.
Councilwoman Rosado?
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez?
Yes, for the community.
Councilwoman Thames?
Yes.
Councilman Winch?
Go Turkey Gang. Yes.
Pass.
That was a yes,
Councilwoman?
That was yes. That was for the community and the turkey game. Yes. Duly noted. So with that concludes our meeting for the evening. Thank you all for joining us in the audience and everyone listening and at home. Good night.